Hello, everyone.
Yeah, it was like Martin Luther King, but for Ram trucks.
He was like a quality of trucks or what?
No, it was like trying to be American.
Yeah.
Step it up, let's go.
It was just weird. It was a lot of stuff like that. Not super sensitive.
It was like trying to be really, really deep, but bad because they were just trying to advertise
for a truck.
Oh, and then the French controversy. French never wanted to be a hologram.
Yeah, oh my gosh, and he did anyways. And JT was like, two fingers up for Prince. It was cool. I still put my fingers up. I will do whatever
you
say.
You still put your fingers up in your sleep.
Hey, Charles.
Hey.
I'm vlogging.
So where did you guys find the game?
This is just kind of, I don't know if this is a little bit off topic, but I thought it was a really cool way to come, or a way of presenting it in the movie Manchester by the Sea, or maybe, yeah, Manchester by the Sea, if anyone's seen it. And, like, this guy's whole life is literally just, like, the worst possible things have just, like, happened to this dude, and, like, he has no joy in life at all, except, like, all he does is just zone out and watch. It's like the Red Sox or the Celtics, he watches, and it's just constantly, like, you see, like, he can't interact with people anymore, and, like, he is constantly tormented by, like, the demons of his past, and, like, what has happened to him, and, like, his own ignorance, and so he's just become, like, the shell of a person, and like, the only thing that, like, is constantly, you hear it a lot in the background, is sports going on, and that's kind of, like, his like one savior in a way, but it's more just kind of like noise to fill the silence.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a question too, but it's a great point to bring up that for a lot of people it's their window to, I mean, their entertainment, but it also is a fulfilling thing to them to be a part of this mass spectrum thing and follow it. Yeah.
I guess from an economic standpoint it's good. Otherwise, like, these companies wouldn't be paying so much money for 30-second segment commercials. Although I think last night, and, like, very recently with Big Stuff, it's becoming, like, shamelessly advertising.
Yeah.
Like, it's just everywhere. Like, I remember at the end of the halftime show, Pepsi was just, like, huge spotlights just everywhere, like, on the field, and it was, like, too much. And I don't know if, like, advertising has any connection to ancient times, but I don't know, that's something they've definitely taken advantage of with big events like this.
Yeah, going off of that, I think it's interesting to hear people who say, like, I don't even watch the Super Bowl for the game, I just watch it for the commercials. And, like, I think that's kind of interesting, like, how sort of, like, sport has evolved over time. Like, I mean, like, the game itself is obviously very intense and memorable, but, like, that, like, part of it has become so ingrained in what the Super Bowl is that the fact that, like, some people don't even, like, care what's happening, they just care about, you know, what brands are being promoted. I just think that's interesting, like, how, I don't know, like, a different, like, culture of the game can evolve out of it and how it's sort of been, you know, monetized that way. But
yeah, there is this whole
thing. Okay, where are we going? Wait, turn around and look. You have to.
We're going to get Slovaki for lunch.
Okay. We're going to get Slovaki. Okay.
Meat on a stick.
Meat on a stick.
And it's banging. So, are we going to Elvis?